Now let's talk about the second type of force, that is electromagnetic force. The name clearly suggests electromagnetic force. With what this involves? This kind of electromagnetic force involves with the charged particles, charges are again of two kinds, positive charge and negative charge. So when some kind of charges are involved, can we always get attractive force or any other kinds of types of force are also possible? Yes, when you have dealing with the positive or negative kind of things, now there are two kinds of things possible. Either it could be attractive force or it could be repulsive force. Attractive force, charge, electromagnetic force is the one related to the charges, which is either could be of attractive types. And clearly you can also mention when it is going to be attractive, when it is going to be repulsive. What is by repulsive? Going away from each other. I think I am going too fast, right? Let me just, okay, because it happened like my speech itself is as such. I eat fast, I sleep fast, I also talk fast. That is the drawback. It may be a drawback for you, but I am very much comfortable with it. Anyways, I'll let me try to go with the lower versions, I mean smaller versions. Electromagnetic force involves with the charged particles. Two important types of charges, positive charge and negative charge. Charges, since types are there, we are going to use types of forces, attractive or repulsive. When can we have attractive force? If it is between one positive charge and one negative charge. The force between a positive charge and a negative charge is called as the attractive force, or vice versa, negative charge and positive charge, opposite charges. Force between opposite charges is attractive. Then when can force be repulsive? Force can be repulsive if it is between two positive charges or two negative charges or same charges. Force between the same charges is called as repulsive force. Force between the opposite charges is called as attractive force. Even this is also independent of the medium. This also do not depend on the medium. This is a basic, say, and we are not going into in-depth analysis. We are just trying to understand how many types of forces exist in the nature. And by default, by in a fundamental form, we have classified forces into, these are all the naturally existing forces. Nobody is giving this force to the universe. Nobody is giving this force to charges. It is having by their nature. Nobody is giving. Now let us talk about the third kind of force. Strong nuclear force. Name itself suggests. What do you mean by nuclear force? If you want to know nuclear force, you should understand the nucleus. What is nucleus? By this time, if you have some knowledge, nucleus, central part of an atom, which consists of certain particles in that called as nucleons. Nucleons are nothing but the constituents present in a nucleus. Constituents, the most important constituents of the nucleus are protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons. Even electrons, negatively charged particle electrons are also present, a bit away from the center. Anyways, strong nuclear force is that this kind of force is the one which exists in the nucleus. Clearly, nuclear force exists inside the nucleus of an atom. And what is the meaning of a strong of this one? This strong makes these things to always bind together. Some particles are present inside the nucleus forever. Protons are always residing inside the nucleus. Neutrons are always residing inside the nucleus. Because they are residing inside the nucleus, they need to be bounded by some kind of a strong force. That force which makes the nucleons to present inside the nucleus is called as a strong nuclear force. And sometimes what happens, because of some mechanisms which you might have not learnt earlier, which you are going to learn in the future classes here in PUC1 and PUC2, you are going to come across a kind of mechanism called as radioactivity. Radium is one of the radioactive elements which is emitting out radiation. So if you find that element of a radium which is giving out radiations, giving out radiations is emitting out radiations, which is doing by its own again, by nature. And again, some particles are going away from that nucleus. Means those are not bound stronger, the strength of that force is not enough to bind them within the nucleus. Nucleus is exhibiting force, but that is not sufficient to make that one to retain inside. That kind of the force is what we call it as a weak nuclear force. Why are we calling it as weak now? Because it is knocking, not making some of the particles to reside inside that. If all the particles of the constituents are residing inside that, that is the reason what it is called as nuclear force. For most of the elements, there exists some kind of, but some, there are some elements in the nature which are not having this strong nuclear force. Some elements in the nature are exhibiting some kind of the thing called as radioactivity. That radioactivity is emission of particles, emission or losing of some kind of particles from the nucleus, and that is the thing which is now said to be born with what kind of a force, that is now called as a weak. These are all happening by means of the nature. There are four important kinds of natures, fundamental forces in the nature. Importantly, we discuss these things in detailed manner of all these forces in the coming up classes, that is gravitational force, electromagnetic force, strong nuclear force and weak nuclear force. Now these can be classified into some other categories also. These are termed in some more categories also. Or I'll give you the names, try to identify under what category they fall under. There is some kind of a thing called as short range force and long range force. What is the meaning of these two words? Range, how much distance, force, name of the force, short. Short range force corresponds to what now? Smaller distances forces. Long range force corresponds to what now? Longer distances force. Now out of these four, which will come under short range force, which will come under long range force? Now talk about this. Will this be a gravitational force corresponds to short range or long range? You should understand that by some examples. What it is? Gravitational force exists between any two masses in the universe. It is there between Earth and the Moon. Moon is always revolving. Why it is revolving? Why it is not going away from the Earth? Because Earth is pulling it towards it, or it is giving some force which is making that one to bound. So is that distance smaller, less, larger, small? Very large. Accordingly, this comes under long range force. Charges also have different sizes expanded or different lengths to them. Accordingly, these two are what I want to tell you is that these two comes under long range forces. Whereas the other two, nucleus is too small, nucleons are inside that much more small. Is that distance small or large? Accordingly, these two will simply come under what kind of forces now? Short range. Out of four fundamental forces, these are classified into two classes, short range force and long range force. These two are called as long range forces and these two are called as short range forces. This is about the fundamental or independent forces which are exhibited naturally. Now, any other derived forces? Derived forces are those which depend upon the fundamental forces. Now, you should name them first, some forces what you know. What I can give you is that a spring force. Where can you see the spring force? Apply. If you drag a spring and leave it, it comes back. We'll see generally boys or we'll see some people will be playing with some kind of springs. Even that also exhibits some kind of force. Spring balances are there in some kind of dharmakanta, is what we call it as wave bridges, right? If you hang some kind of a mass, it expands to measure the wave. That is called as the force exerted by the spring upon the application of mass onto that end is called as a spring force. Tensional force, tension in a string, thread. String, if you connect something to a string in the form of a stone or something and if you hold it, you can find some stiffness in the string. That stiffness is what we call it as tension. And muscular force, bodybuilders will have huge muscles, they'll ready to fight, right? We generally feel that those with big muscles will have higher strengths. But I am, though having lesser muscles, have much more strength. I am also good at muscle power, my muscle power. But compared with me, your muscle power is less. Maybe some of you may have more than me. That's a secondary thing. But kids or smaller people in front of you will have lesser muscle strength. Or how much force you can exhibit by using your hands or muscles is called as muscular force. Molecular force, like you can now call many number of forces like this. Frictional force. Any idea where do you come across this frictional force? Friction. Force exerted upon one object because of the other, which always take place in opposite direction. Anyways, I don't want to confuse you much with the lengthier terms and all. It's a clear thing that we are going to learn all these things in the coming up chapter. This is just the beginning. Physical world is just the beginning to understand what are you going to learn in the coming up classes. How are we going to give the introduction to physics is what we say. Or in the meaning of physical world, we do come across various kinds of things, the basic thing or different kinds of things what we learn in coming up chapters. And I wanted to tell you one more important thing also, that it's not that what you learn in P1, P2 is the end of physics. It is just the basic part of the physics. The in-depth analysis of that, especially in P1, P2, you are not going to get anything in detail. Only the outline. We also introduced to this only outline. All these things are introduced to us just to get the basic formulas. Outline, in-depth analysis. Once you get your branch allocation in BTech, you utter the subject you choose, electronics, chemical. Depending upon that, you are going to choose one topic and you are going to get expertised in that. And I also want to make it very clear that in physical science textbook of Telugu Academy, what we follow, some kind of topics are just given only the outline formula. Neither the beginning of that would be given, nor the complete end of that. In the middle, from somewhere you take some formula and that formula would be given. You should understand that kind of formula. So for example, as I said, radioactivity. We don't have much of this. The concept of radioactivity starts in the second year, ending part of physics. But some formulas of this would come across in some first chapter, second chapter, third chapter of first PCM. What we have to do, you have to take the formula correspondingly, just try to get the basic knowledge on that and apply that formula. Understanding physics involves understanding the nature. And you'll understand that more easily once you have a love on the subject. If you want to develop more physics, you should have more love towards the subject. In simple words, I can tell you, physics is love. If you love physics, you'll get your life easy. That's all for now for this session. Anything left over in this chapter, I'll just cross check and I'll put one more video based upon that. Or these things will be sufficient to understand the concept related to. I'll be coming up again with some more chapter in the later one. But as of now, my kind suggestion to every student is that have a complete brush up of the things. You might feel that my language is so fast or my communication is, my words may not be so much clear. Please listen to the video again and again. And you are very much free to comment in the comment section with any kind of a doubt what you have. But make sure that it always takes some time to get the things understand in your way. In order to understand the things in your way, you should take some time, because this is just the beginning of your life, a new life, which is almost 6 years left here. There would be a lot of difficulties, especially for the Telugu medium students, in understanding the language. You can request for some other, if you need any other help in understanding these things also, you can ask me that. You can ask me for any kind of a help. Not only me, any faculty in the university will be always ever ready to help you out in overcoming your obstacles. Just feel free to comment us. Hey, I would be sharing my personal number also with you at a later stage. You can feel free to talk to me. I was also like you people, a very shy guy to talk to the people. But later, life skills are the things what you need to develop. You should be in a position to talk, able to communicate. Without talking, by sitting in our places, nothing will come out. Will anybody give you something without, when you don't come out? No one will give you anything except mother. No one except mother and father, no one will give you. And now the time you are getting is to build up, to throw back, to give back to your society or to your parents or to someone else. You should now turn yourself into the responsible citizens.
accordingly. Plenty of things will come in this way. Have focus, have patience, take the help whenever you want, and we will be very much happy to help you. Stay safe, all of you. Have a quick, thorough revision session. Till we meet for the next time, keep revising the concepts. Feel free to comment. Thank you. Have a nice day.